Pete. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Chris.
How are you keeping today?
Not too bad. Just been Sissy's bought a bike, and I've just been putting that together. It's took me about 3 hours. So I've just been doing that in the garage.
Pedal bike.
Pedal bike, yeah.
How is everyone keeping? How's the family?
They're all good. Yeah, everybody's good, Chris. Thank you. Is yours all right?
Yeah. I'll keep it well, mate. Yeah.
Yeah. So far, so good. That's all we can do.
Yeah. You said last time you got your mum staying with you, and on the Instagram the other day, you had a video of you helping her with her exercises and keeping her fit and healthy. Is she keeping well? It was nice to see.
She is keeping well, me mother. She has got a bad chest, and she suffers with shortness of breath. So, you know, giving her exercise in the lungs, that's the method behind the madness. So I'm giving her exercise. I was doing it every day, but now I've moved it to like once every second day to give her a rest. But she's a lot better. She's moving around better, and she's breathing better as well. Because even at that age, you know, we're just sitting down, drinking tea, eating, you know, you get overweight. And, you know, that shortness of breath, what she's got, goes even worse. So now, since I've been walking her, she's lost a bit of weight, and she's breathing a lot better. So far, so good on that, Chris.
We said we'd do another one, Pete. We chatted last week. We said we'd have a catch-up. We didn't speak much about boxing, and we said we'd have a chat about your life and some of your moments in your life and go back a bit. I believe a bit of boxing news. Peter Fury's put the gloves back on. You just was telling me then before we... on there, you've been getting the gloves on and doing a bit of sparring with Hughie. Tell us about that.
Oh God, it's what can you do? You know what? I've never had the gloves on for years. You know, because obviously we're training them and stuff. And I got the gloves on, and you know he's got nobody to train with. So I said, just come up here. And you know, it's all about, you know, I want to just, although I've got him on the pads, I want to do like pad session, and I still need him to hit a moving target. You know, which is not much of a moving target, I almost said, bit. But still, it's a moving target. So I'm doing some body sparring with him. Obviously, he's taking his time with me, not hitting me hard and stuff. But yeah, so it's very difficult. So I've been doing six 3 minute rounds with him. I can't do any more than that because obviously, you know, it's hard work. So but yeah, it makes me. It brought back some memories, let's say. Yeah. No, enjoyed it with him. It's good. Yeah.
Was he doing it southpaw or orthodox?
He mixes up well, so you know, especially to the body. You know, he rotates a lot, so it's the moves that we've been working on, as far as I'm concerned, you know, with him in front of me doing it, he's working very well. You know, he's got such beautiful footwork. He's got skills to bear. And what I said to him is, I think he's mastered his craft very well now. Although he had it all up here, there's one thing being relaxed and doing it. You know, so what I'm telling him to do now is draw the leads. You know, keep them busy, let them react, let them throw, because he can afford to let them do that with his skill set. You know, and just take his time and counter off what they're doing. You know, don't try and be rushing to be first all the time. You know, relax, get into it, and let your boxing do it for yourself. You know, relax up here. Don't push anything. You know, because like I said, the more you rush things, your skill set drops. So all as Hughie's got to do is just let his skills do the work. And he's and I believe that's what will make him the finished article, when he just turns that corner for that little piece of jigsaw, which I believe he has got now. So just working on stuff like that. So I did need to body spar him to see how he is with that. Because although I'm getting on, I'm still 18 stone and I can hit, you know what I mean? So basically, you know, he's still got to think a bit, a little bit, Chris.
Did you win a few rounds?
Sorry?
You won a few rounds?
No, I never probably won one, but I've done 6 threes, that's all I can tell you. But no, listen. You can't put youth where there's age, I'm afraid. And You know, he's it's a workout for Hughie, but still, it's good for me as well. So it's getting me a little bit fit, and I can see what we're working on, what he needs to do. Because even when he's doing it with me, I'll say, right, get over here more. You know, because if I can cut him off, it's not working right, is it? So just little things like that. So it's better to have that proper contact, not just holding the pads.
Yeah, makes sense. So toughening up the abs and peak body sparring how's the six pack?
Well, it's very good when I sit down, Chris. I don't think I've seen a six pack since I was about 30, in my early 30s. No six pack. No, I'm healthy. I bought a bike, as you know, and I set off doing 7.5 mile. In the morning. And the first week, after 2 weeks of that, after 1 week of that, I jumped to 15 mile into the second week. And on the third week, I've done 22.5 mile. So I'm on my third week now, so I've done 22.5. I'm doing 22.5 mile, which takes me, I've done an hour and 34 yesterday, and I've done an hour and 30 today. So it's good getting there.
It's Cotswolds, aren't you? Yeah.
Yeah, there's hills as well.
Lovely ride around there. Yeah.
There is. It's good. I burned 2,200 calories. So it's a lot. I can't see the difference. I've been doing it for a week. I maybe lost a pound, maybe two, max. So I don't know about being a slim Whitman on it, that's for sure.
Yeah, keeps your mind right, though, doesn't it, I suppose. Yeah, that's the thing, exercise.
You do, you feel better when you've done it. You have come off the bike, have a shower. You know, it's perfect. It is good. Good for the mind.
Going back to you there, I mentioned about Southpaw. I was joking a bit, but that was one of the topics before the fight in December, his last fight. You were saying we're going to see a difference in him, his style, how he was going to box. And we did. And you spoke about now how he was a natural Southpaw all along, but for one thing and another. The way he'd been, maybe, you know, he'd worked it from young and result of injury as well. He'd gone up through most of his career as orthodox. We've seen him switch a little bit in fights and stuff like that, but, you know, generally the consensus was he was a orthodox.
You know, we never got to see him properly in his last fight because when he switched, he'd had an operation on his knee. I think only 8-10 weeks before that fight. So basically, he was still like pretty weak on the knee. He was doing all right in training, but when he said he switched in the fight, he felt like it gived a little bit, so it made him unsure of it. So then he decided to stay in the orthodox position. So otherwise, we'd have seen a lot more of it. But like I said, he as soon as the fight ended, he went back to see the doctors, had a CT scan put on it, and because the operation on the knee was done relatively similar time his training camp was being ready, you know, it caused a lot of inflammation. So you know, he's had some more treatments on it, and he's been resting it up and just doing a lot of physio on the knee without any stress. But that was a problem, because the doctor said, really, you need 6 or 7 months after the operation, we need to get the knee strong. So obviously he only had 8-10 weeks before that. So like I said, when he switched up in the fight, he felt unsteady on it. And he said he felt it like give a little bit. And he said it made it put him off. But he said rather than take a chance, he just decided to just keep in the orthodox. But what's happened with Hughie, because he's genuinely left-handed, doesn't mean to say he's going to stay there. But what it's caused him to get great balance on either side. So his right hands are coming off I look much better. Don't ask me why that is. I can't tell you. But because he's now naturally in a southpaw stance, when he switches up, he's got the right hands there anyway. And even when he's in the orthodox position, he can still get the right hand off a lot better. So maybe that was just missing in his game, why he couldn't get his right hand off. But he's certainly getting it off now. So maybe that's fixed the problem.
It was something that was even perplexing you, wasn't it? I mean, people were saying, you know, they wanted him to you know, more of a punch output. But you've said it yourself in the past, how it was frustrating you, and how in camp you was going to, these are the things you're going to be working on. And you even alluded to people want to see, you know, a good fight, and you want him involved in good fights as well. And you feel like you've remedied that situation now.
Yeah, you know, I've always said, you know, going back, but obviously it's not happened in Hughie's case, so you know, I'll take responsibility for that. But I've always said, if you remember going back over the years, fighters should fight to the DNA. You know, whatever, how the build is, or what the DNA is. Now, Hughie is a natural left-handed person. So obviously I think that's what was missing. And to be fair, even the few body spars I've had myself with him, and I'm left-handed myself, you know, text after me there, because I'm left-handed. You know, but in the, when I'm switching up myself, I feel a lot better from both sides, if you know what I mean. You know, and I've never had the gloves on for years. So I can see the benefits of it, and I can see where he's been going wrong with that. So I think it's because he's never been using the southpaw stance at all. He's just constantly been in the right, when really he needed to switch up. So he has got the best of both worlds. So I'm excited to see, you know, in the next in his next fight, because we really never got to see much at all in the last one. Although he blasted that opponent out, you know, whatever we really got to see is his very good boxing skills and everything else. You see him switch up and he landed the straight left. But you notice when he switched up, he never moved his back foot in. So when he landed the left, it was like going through the target. Instead, he switched up and just threw the left. It landed, but it landed on the end of it. You know, it landed at the full extension at the end of it. So it never really done a lot of damage. But I can tell you, but that's partly because of the knee. But he is holding a lot of... he's a different fighter today, to be fair, to him. He's grown up, he's mature as well. And he's hitting with some good power as well. So it's exciting for Hughie. And hopefully, getting back busy and get hold of these rematches if we can and correct them.
Yeah. He's had some real setbacks in terms of you know, defeats at the highest level of the game as well. But it's not deterred him. He's just gets straight back in there, and before you know it, you can see Hughie Fury's got another fight lined up. He's not let it deter him. He's a really strong man. Bear in mind, what is he, just turned 25. Strong-minded kid, and he must be very proud of him in that aspect, that he just will not give up his dream.
What you got to look at, this is a young man learning his trade, you know, and when you look at it, you know, he's fighting guys that's all at the best, or just about past the best, or whatever you want to call it, but the very experienced guys, and some of them are peaking. You know, Pulev's at his best as well. You know, he's better than what he's ever been. You know, and Hughie's a young man giving all of them trouble. You know, so, you know, there's the difference. So when it does click, which it is clicking, I can tell you now, you know, it'll be, it's a matter of time for Hughie before he wins belts. You know, not one to say he's going to beat this and do this and do that. But let's get him back in the ring and let's see. But I'm highly confident, you know, so is he. So, you know, if that's the best they can do with a young fella, you know, who can't really land the right hand, who's getting in there and just using the jab and using boxing ability, if that's the best they can do with him under that scenario, you know, it's going to be a different ball game, isn't it? Because now he's got two hands and he's hitting with a lot more power. And to be fair as well, he's a bigger unit. You know, he's got a lot more muscle mass on him. He's turning into now, he's a proper mature big heavyweight. You know, he's walking around 18 stone plus. You know, so trained down, he's still 17 plus. So, you know, before he was like 15, 12, 16. You've seen as the years has gone on, his weight's crept up. Apart from when he was younger and he was carrying a lot of body fat. You know, but now he's lean, got less body fat, and he's got more muscle, which is partly due to his age.
When you consider heavyweights mature in late 20s, arguably even 30s, you know, some of the biggest wins have been from heavyweights in the 30s. He's got a long way to go.
Well, you can, in the heavyweight division, is different to any other weight. Because, like I said, you know, a Jack Russell, 6 months, is fully developed. You know, a heavyweight in a dog, you know, a Great Dane, 3 years old, between 3 and 4. You know, bigger the dog, longer it takes. You know, Rottweilers, 18 months, 2 years. You know, there's a difference. That's it. That's in, you relate to animals. You know, so like I said, it's it is heavyweights. And I think I know what I'm doing with heavyweights because I've watched them over the years. It is. They've got to really, they've got to mature into it. But yes, and he's 25 now, and he's getting stronger, and he's getting better. So very interesting. And he's got vast, you know, this is a kid who's got 27 pro fights. He's never been down on the floor. He's took no counts. He's gone through world-level fights, injured with one eye, you know, and he's come through all of them tests. You know, he's only fell short by just not doing enough. You know, so people need to really sit up and think to themselves, how much potential has this lad got? Because he's got loads of it. He's only been using a third of his arsenal. But like I said, he's now got 100% going, and I'm really excited for him. I'm excited for him. Like I said, that opponent he had last time, he blew him away. You know, but like, you know, he fought Jermaine Franklin, took him 10 rounds, gave him all the trouble he could deal with. You know, the kid wasn't a world level fighter, but he was an awkward type opponent. You know, very awkward. You know, if you let somebody like that in the fight, give you a nightmare. You know, he wasn't allowed this time, and he got rid of him sharp enough. Which is a testament to how he's hitting, because the kid who he boxed last, he was durable. He's not somebody that falls in a round or two, you know.
It's not always easy getting opponents either, is it? Especially, you know, heavyweight. There's only a certain pool of fighters, and some are ready, some are not. So, and we don't know when boxing is going to be back on anyway. But just you know, Hughie's keeping himself fit. When it does get round to it, what sort of direction are you thinking of going with him? Are you looking at, you know, a couple of tune-up fights and then back in there with maybe some kind of an eliminator? Or is there a plan? Would you look at? You know, maybe fighting some domestic fights, maybe to get the ball rolling again. You know, maybe we can't get a foreign opponent or things like that. Have you thought that far or that deep into it?
I haven't really. Hughie's pretty up for any kind of decent fight, so we'll have a look and see what we get offered. So, like I said, we'll have to just wait and see who we get. But I'd like somebody probably a bit better than the last one. You know, or even straight into a decent fight. Just depends, but I'd like to keep him busy. So maybe another fight a little bit better than this one. And then, you know, hopefully he's got that. He's ready to step straight into another fight straight away. Something of quality again. So I think he's had one now, another fight, and, you know, we'll see who's out there and what fight can be made.
Two or three fights, work on the new stuff, you know, the new techniques and things like that. Seems a good idea, and then look to getting some kind of title mix. So, you know, I don't think anyone could begrudge him that after all that, you know, the tough fights that he's had on the bounce, if you like, other than the last one, if you like, and that. But you know what I mean on these big ones he's had.
Yeah, but like I said, we need somebody decent who's durable, and you know, we'll put up a good fight, because obviously I'm not saying about this guy because he hit him right, but there's some good, durable opponents out there. So we'll have to see. So we'll have a look, Chris. Somebody that can give him a decent fight, so it needs to be on a decent level.
You said you is a southpaw like yourself. Do you see a lot in yourself in Hughie as a person? Now he's growing into a mature bloke and that, and you know, he's got, like I said, he's got this real determination and that kind of thing. You know, what are the characteristics you see in him that you see in yourself?
Well, obviously he's my son, isn't he? So he's got to have something there. But like I said, not really going back over our lives, he's not like me. Because obviously he's a lot more grounded than me. He's more settled. You know, he's focused. Focuses on boxing. He knows what he wants, and he's not, he's never had this, I don't know, maybe he's got a bit of his mother's nature or something, because he's more, a lot more placid than I was, you know? So, like I said, no, he's a gentleman, he's a nice young man, You know, when I was younger, I was always a nice fella, but I could turn on a sixpence. You know, so he's not like me in that regard. But like I said, and he's dedicated to one thing, where I do a multitude of different things. You know, probably anything under the sun. So he's not like me in that regard. So like I said, we are different. He's determined. He's got that steely determination, which I suppose I've had. So there is, obviously there's some likenesses there. But he's got his head screwed on a lot more than what I did when I was younger. Obviously, I was clever in business and stuff like that. But that doesn't mean to say you're clever in a whole thing. You know, he's very, so we are different in that regard. You know, he knows what he wants and he's dedicated to one thing, which to get forward in life and to be successful, whether it's in business, boxing, swimming, whatever you're going to do, you know, most successful people are the ones that's dedicated to the one thing. So in that regard, no, he's doing a lot better than what I did when I was younger, in all regards. So he's good. So we are different in that respect.
I referred to his determination to come back from defeat and keep going and come back, you know, adversity in his boxing career. I know you've had your ups and downs in life, Pete. You've had to come back from low times in your life. I've spoke to you before about this, you know. So in that regard as well, I mean, where was you at 25 years old? You just said he's just turned 25 now. Looking back at them, where was you and where was your focus and where was you going in life at that point?
Yeah, he takes after me in that field because I've never laid down to anything when I was younger. Just was not in my vocabulary at all. So if there's a wall there, you know, I'd find a way to get over it or through it or whatever. You know, I wouldn't take anything like that. So yeah, he takes after me like that. But when I was 25, you know, I was married early. We had children and stuff. I had businesses, and I was doing very well for myself when I was that age. But I was also into other things. I was in skullduggery as well, you know. So, you know, it's like anything else. It's the way you grow up. You get reputations and stuff. And one thing leads to another. So, that's what I'm saying to you. You know, I'm doing business and I drift off to the left or the right. I wouldn't just concentrate on what I was doing. You know, nothing was an obstacle for me. You know, I'd turn me on to anything and have a go at anything, basically. You know, without even thinking sometimes of the consequences. You know, so, yeah. We all know where that ended up.
Yeah, you had to spend some time at Majesty's pleasure. Quite a few years as well, Pete. It was, if you don't mind talking about that, we can... We can talk about it, but that, it was a few years ago now, and it was. How do you look back on them times? And I mean, you said, you know, you was at that point in your life where, you know, how would you look back on that guy, and now, and where, you know, where was he going, and where was his life at that point?
When I was younger, I know I got 10 years for drugs and conspiracy to supply Class B drugs and stuff. But it wasn't about the drugs. I didn't need drugs. I had millions of pounds already. So I didn't need the drug trade. But look, nobody since the craze run a city, you know. So I thought, that's a challenge. Nobody's done that except them. I'll do that. So that's what we did.